up so early that the sun is... Look how dark it is outside. Lol, joke. We're starting this vlog at... What time is it, Jazz?
It's 25 past 7 in the evening. Good job the team give me content.
Jazz, why do seagulls fly over the sea?
I don't know.
Because if they didn't, they'd be bagels. No, that was wrong. You laughed at that and I didn't even deliver that right.
Because if they flew over the bay, they'd be bagels.
Well, I did kind of already put that together.
Okay, good. Sweet. Well,
I did get it.
Hold on a second. Take that.
It was still...
Take two. Also, apparently one of the... Well, a couple of the team are getting a bit annoyed with the dab. Hold this a second. Yeah, take that team. Anyway, they want us to replace it with this. Let that one sink in.
Why? What happened?
We have to get out of here.
What happened? What's seeing? What happened?
I can't. I feel unsafe.
It's a meme that's been going on recently.
Like that.
Right, hold on, do it again. Kind of
is that
like.
What you- I saw this the other day.
You nailed it.
What happened to the vlog?
Wouldn't be a Team Richie vlog without a citrus elderflower knocker.
And also because it's 7:30, this has no caffeine, which is great. Means I can sleep tonight. Since being with Marius the other day, back on the breakdance hype.
Even though we never had a penny. Yo, we always have spirit. They can burn my flesh, but they can't touch my spirit. They want to take away my freedom.
I got the shot. Get back in the car.
Look at that. Smack bag on the green.
Cause even when we never had a penny, yo, we always have spirit. All we hear is siren and stained fire. Hold your head higher.
Get it, Jazz. Get it. Oh, turn your brake lights back on, bruh.
That was Super Jeff after his course.
Super Jeff is good.
Are you
trying to stop us from getting our gains?
Yeah, man, that's it, my bad.
Alright, Jack?
You're locking you're in trouble, that's it. Don't shut this door, is that?
Nice new lifters.
Yeah, Cuban heels.
What have you been doing?
Today I've had to coach twice, double session. So it's time for bedtime, mate. I'm tired.
Every day you're
hustling.
Jack, what's your favourite animal?
Sloth.
Cool. You're like one of those cute lollipop puppies.
Did you see the photo I sent you today of Thomas' puppy? How cute is it? Even Craig said. It's like an actual teddy bear.
Team Jazz wants a dog. I don't know what that's saying, put down below what that's saying, but I think she wants a dog, and to be honest, I'd love a dog too. Sparky technically isn't ours, it's my grandma's.
And he's technically a grumpy old man in a sausage doll body.
Look at all the barbells. They're everywhere.
Barbell, 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 barbell. Barbell, barbell.
What are we starting off today doing?
Tying my shoelaces.
We are front squatting. Front squats today. Recently I've been doing a lot of like warming up for front squats because this is what my front squat looks like when I'm stiff, raw, not warm at all.
This is horrendous.
I'm like an ironing board.
Look at these elbows.
I can barely raise the bar on my
feet. I'll take you through my stretching routine to get moving. Starting from the most distal, working to the most proximal. Great exercise for stretching off your calves. Push the plate down through your knee, keeping your heel pressed against the floor. Should feel the stretch up the back.
Or if you're really small and the plate's really big, just lean over it. Your body weight does the same job. And it can be there like a walking stick. Stability.
Hug it. Exercise 2, hip flexors. More hip flexors specific. Balance, more quadriceps specific. Because quads do act as one of those flexors.
This is a great exercise to warm up if you are one of those people that ends up doing a squat and caving. People that tend to do this. So your torso falls forwards.
That's usually very commonly caused by hip flexor tightness because you've been sat down all day. Slash, you work seated a lot of the time. And so stretching those hip flexors and the quads allow you to keep a more upright torso in the front squat.
Exercise 3, lats and groin. Sit in a wide angle stance and back stretches out the groin.
Try not to round your back. Try and keep a nice flat back. Reach your hands out as far as possible.
If you can do that pretty easily, bring in a plate.
Raise your hands, more of a stretch on the lats.
The lats are probably the most common area that people are tight when they come to the front squat. Tight lats, elbows can't get up and under the bar. You'll usually find that when you start to have a heavy load on you, your upper back will round and it will be weak. If you have the mobility in the lats to keep that really high elbow throughout the whole range of motion in the squat, you're gonna have a much stronger front squat and be much more positionally stronger. If you can keep your elbows up here instead of down here, you've got a much stronger upper back. Ankles done, knees done, hips done, lats done. Next, triceps. Triceps, pretty simple stretch.
Open up here. CrossFit, we do a hell of a lot of shoulder to overhead work, load of pushing work, load of burpee pushing work. You can get pretty tight triceps.
If your triceps are tight, as well as your lats, it's just gonna mean that you're not gonna be able to get your elbow. I just like this stretch.
Simple, but it works. Kill them.
And then the final move, if you struggle with wrist mobility, that I do to warm up just for kind of 2 or 3 minutes before I then get under the bar, is literally put your weight over your wrist. If that means you start here, that's absolutely fine if you have kind of tight flexors, forearm flexors. But then what you want to do over time is just be able to sit back, put your bum towards your heels, trying to keep the palm of your hand flat. Go down, hold it for 5 to 10 seconds, come back out, slowly, and then fall back into it again. Yes, science. So now my front squat should be a lot better. Now I'll just let the weight work on my range of motion. People say that you shouldn't do static stretches before training, and it's been scientifically proven to decrease your strength. But if you're looking at positional strength over kind of what you'll lose from static stretching, positional strength is always going to be more valuable than being in a bad position but being stronger. So build the strength in the good position, not in a bad position. Yes, science.
Good tip.
Science! When you pass by. Oh, feels heavy today. My eyeball's gonna pop out.
Look at this team. No knees falling in. Knees stay out every time. Da-da-da-da. Killing it, Jazz.
And you did these yesterday. I was meant to wait 2 days before I did them again.
How does it feel now? Your knees don't fall out.
So much better. They still go in, like, the heavier and more tired I get, they do dip in a little bit more, but I feel so much stronger now and in such a better position driving up. It's good. It's taking some time though. Time and practice. But we're getting there.
Every day we're hustling.
You have crap days of training. Yesterday morning was great, yesterday night was crap, today is crap, but tomorrow might be great. As long as you give your 100% on each day, then that's all that matters. You're not going to change the world and have a great session every day. You are going to change the world if you keep moving and maybe have crap sessions along the way, but those crap sessions are what's going to separate you from being great and just being good. Because I could quit right now, but I'm not going to. You know why, Jazz?
Because we didn't quit.
Ta-da! Look at me, Jazz. Mistake.
and put me in America, there'd be 53 states.
Come on.
I made that joke yesterday, but it's a good one.
Feeling of comfort all this time I've been lying, and I never had someone.